Hello students, welcome to my channel Learning History Made Easy. In today's video, I will be explaining about Madhvacharya and his philosophy. Before going into the video, if anyone is seeing the channel for the first time or if you have not subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe and share it with your friends. So without wasting time, let us get into the video. So as I told, in today's video, we are going to see about Madhvacharya. Madhvacharya, he was born at a place called as Pajaka near Udupi. So the birthplace of Madhvacharya is Pajaka near Udupi. He was born in 1238 CE. So, Madhvacharya was born in Pajaka near Udupi in 1238 CE. The parents of Madhvacharya were Madhyageha Narayana Bhatta, and Vedavati. They were the parents of Madhvacharya. Madhyageha Narayana Bhatta and Vedavati were the parents of Madhvacharya. Madhvacharya's early name, he was called by another name in his childhood. His early name was Vasudeva. Vasudeva was the early name of Madhvacharya. And he also had two titles. The main two titles of Madhvacharya, one is he was called as Purna Pratnya and also he was called as Ananda Tirtha. So Madhvacharya was called as Purna Pratnya as well as Ananda Tirtha. He was a renowned scholar. Madhvacharya was a renowned scholar in different subjects like Vedas, Puranas, history, etc. So he was well versed in Vedas, Purana, history, etc. So he was born at Pajaka near Udupi in 1238 CE. His parents were Madhyageha Narayana Bhatta and Vedavati. His early name was Vasudeva and he was also called as Purna Pratnya and Ananda Tirtha. He was a scholar in different subjects like Vedas, Purana, history, etc. Now what was the life of Madhvacharya? He began to have Madhvacharya's teacher was Achyuta Preksha. The teacher of Madhvacharya was Achyuta Preksha. And this teacher, Achyuta Preksha, was a follower of Advaita philosophy. Achyuta Preksha was a follower of Advaita philosophy. But what happened was, Madhvacharya started to have difference in opinions with his teacher. So Madhvacharya started to have difference in opinion with the philosophy of his teacher. Difference in opinion with his teacher. That is, teacher is Achyuta Preksha, with his teacher. So when this difference of opinion was still there, Madhvacharya travelled to North India. He travelled to different place. In North India, he visited places like Kashi, Kedara, Gaya, etc. So Achyuta Preksha was a teacher of Madhvacharya. Madhvacharya's teacher was Achyuta Preksha. This teacher was a follower of Advaita philosophy. But Madhvacharya started to have difference in opinion with his teacher. So Madhvacharya's philosophy was much different from Advaita philosophy. He travelled over North India and he visited Kashi, Kedara, Gaya, etc. And once from his travel, he bought the idols of Krishna and Balarama from North India. So the statue of Krishna and Balarama were bought from North India by Madhvacharya. And this Krishna and Balarama statue, which he brought from North India, He installed in different places. Krishna, Lord Krishna statue, he installed in Udupi, and Balarama statue he installed at Malpe. So he installed both these statues, which were brought from North India. One statue was installed in Udupi, and one statue was installed at Malpe. So that was what was done by Madhvacharya after his visit of North India. After that, he established Ashtamatas at Udupi. Madhvacharya established Ashtamatas or eight matas at Udupi. And some of the important among these Ashtamatas, we can say Sode Matha, Siruru Matha, Siruru Matha, Krishnapura Matha, Krishnapura Matha, etc. were some of the important among these Ashtamatas established by Madhvacharya at Udupi. Then after his visit of North India, he also visited some places in South India like Kanchi, Madurai, Rameshwaram. All these places he visited in South India, Rameshwaram, etc. So he visited North India, also he visited places like Kanchi, Madurai, Rameshwaram in South India. Madhvacharya died at the age of 80. At the age of 80, Madhvacharya passed away, and he had some important works. Some important works of Madhvacharya are Gita Bhashya, Gita Bhashya, Anubhashya, Gita Bhashya, Anubhashya, Brahma Sutra, etc. were some important works of Madhvacharya. So Madhvacharya established Ashtamatas at Udupi. Some of the important of those were Sode Matha, Siruru Matha and Krishnapura Matha. He visited South India, and in South India he visited Kanchi, Madurai, Rameshwaram, Kanyakumari, etc. He died at the age of 80. Some of his important works are Gita Bhashya, Anubhashya, Brahma Sutra, etc. were some important works of Madhvacharya. So now let us just revise through the points which we studied till now. Madhvacharya, 1238 to 1317 CE. He was born at Pajaka near Udupi in 1238 CE. His parents were Madhyageha Narayana Bhatta and Vedavati. His earlier name was Vasudeva. He was also known as Purna Prajna and Ananda Tirtha. He became a renowned scholar in Vedas, Puranas and history. Achyuta Preksha was his teacher, and he was a follower of Advaita philosophy. Madhvacharya began to have difference of opinion with his teacher and developed his own philosophy. He travelled over North India, and he visited Kashi, Kedara, Gaya, etc. He brought the idols of Krishna and Balarama from North India and installed Krishna at Udupi and Balarama at Malpe. Ashtamatas was established by him at Udupi. Sode Matha, Siruru Matha, Krishnapura Matha, etc. are some among them. He also visited sacred places in South India like Kanchi, Madurai, Rameshwaram, Kanyakumari, etc. Madhvacharya died at the age of 80. Some of his important works are Gita Bhashya, Anubhashya, Brahma Sutra, etc. Now let us see about the philosophy of Madhvacharya. So we saw about the life of Madhvacharya. Now let us see about his philosophy. His philosophy is called as Dvaita philosophy. We already know that he did not agree with the philosophy of his teacher Achyuta Preksha, that is, he did not agree with Advaita philosophy. So Madhvacharya developed his own philosophy, that is Dvaita philosophy. His philosophy is called as Dvaita, meaning dualism. The philosophy of Madhvacharya is Dvaita or dualism. He disagreed with the Advaita philosophy. We have already studied, he disagreed with the Advaita philosophy of Shankaracharya. He disagreed with the Advaita philosophy. According to him, according to Madhvacharya, there are three entities. Okay, according to him, there are three entities in this world. There are three entities. One is matter, that is jada. The next one is soul, that is atma or jivatma, as we tell. And the last one is God, that is paramatma. Paramatma. Okay, so according to him, there are three entities. One is matter, that is the jada. Next is soul or the jivatma. And the third one is God, that is paramatma. And according to Madhvacharya, God is independent. God is independent. So from these three entities, God is independent, and soul and matter are dependent on him, that is on God. Soul and matter, that is jada and atma, are dependent on him, dependent on God. So God is independent, and soul and matter, that is jada and atma, are dependent on the God. So that was the philosophy said by Madhvacharya. So Madhvacharya's philosophy is called as Dvaita philosophy or dualism. He disagreed with the Advaita philosophy of Shankaracharya. He said that there are three entities, that is matter, jada, soul, atma, and God, paramatma. According to him, God is independent, and soul and matter are dependent on God. So that was his philosophy. So he said about three entities, but why is his philosophy called as dualism? So he said that individual soul and God, see, he was only telling about individual soul and God are two different entities. According to him, individual soul and God are two different entities, and hence he called his philosophy as dualism or Dvaita philosophy. Dvaita philosophy, because he is telling about telling about two different entities, that is soul, that is atma, and God. That is why his philosophy is called as Dvaita philosophy. Okay, so now according to Madhvacharya, five fundamental differences are there between these three entities. There are five fundamental differences between these three entities. Between these three entities. Three entities here, we can once more recall, matter. Three entities are matter, jada, soul, jivatma, and God, paramatma. So let us see, according to Madhvacharya, what are the five differences between this matter, jada, and matter, soul, and God. So according to him, the first difference is soul and God cannot merge into one another. Soul and God cannot merge into one another. One another, that is jada and paramatma, cannot merge with one another. They are two different entities, so they cannot merge with one another. So that is the first difference between these three entities. The second difference is a soul does not merge with another soul. Okay, a soul does not merge with another soul. Another soul, that is one jivatma and another jivatma, cannot merge with each other. Okay, so jivatma and paramatma cannot merge with each other. That is the first one. Then one jivatma and another jivatma, or one soul and another soul, cannot merge with each other. Now the third difference is matter does not merge with God. Matter does not merge with God. That is jada cannot merge with Paramatma. Jada and Paramatma cannot merge with each other. Matter does not merge with God. Next one, matter does not merge with soul. Matter does not merge with soul. That is, Jada and Jivatma cannot merge with each other. Matter does not merge with soul. And the last difference is, matter does not merge with another matter. Matter does not merge with another matter. That is, one Jada and another Jada cannot merge with each other. Matter does not merge or mix with another matter. So these are the five fundamental differences between matter, soul and God. That is, soul and God cannot merge with one another. One soul cannot merge with another soul. Matter does not merge with God. Matter does not merge with soul. Matter does not merge with another matter. Okay, so the first two is about soul. Soul cannot merge with God and soul cannot merge with another soul. Then the next three is about matter. Matter does not merge with God. Matter does not merge with soul. Matter does not merge with another matter. These are the five differences between the three entities which was said by Madhvacharya, and that is his philosophy, which is called as Dvaita philosophy. Now let us just revise the points which we have seen now. Dvaita philosophy. His philosophy is known as Dvaita or dualism. He disagreed with the Advaita philosophy. According to him, there are three entities: matter, Jada; soul, Jivatma; and God, Paramatma. God is independent and soul and matter are dependent on him. He said that the individual soul and God are two different entities, and hence it is called as Dvaita philosophy. He recognized five fundamental differences between the soul, matter and God. Soul and God cannot merge with one another. A soul does not merge with another soul. Matter does not merge with God. Matter does not merge with soul. Matter does not merge with another matter. So these were the five differences between the soul, matter and God. Now let us see some important questions regarding this topic. Which was the birthplace of Madhvacharya? Pajaka, near Udupi. What was the earlier name of Madhvacharya? Vasudeva. Name the philosophy of Madhvacharya. Dvaita philosophy. When and where was Madhvacharya born? He was born in 1238 CE at Pajaka near Udupi. Who were the parents of Madhvacharya? Madhyagriha Narayana Bhatta and Vedavati. Name any two mathas established by Madhvacharya. Sode Matha and Siruru Matha. Name any two works of Madhvacharya. Gita Bhashya, Anubhashya. Explain the life and teachings of Madhvacharya. That answer is explained in the video. Life, the first part you will have to write, and in teachings you have to write about Dvaita philosophy. So these are the important questions regarding this topic. I hope you have understood all the points regarding Madhvacharya very clearly. If you have any doubts, you can ask in the comment section. And please don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel, because even now half of the viewers who are seeing without subscribing. So please do subscribe and also click the bell button to receive notifications when I upload new videos. Your likes and comments will be of a great encouragement for me to make more and more videos. So I hope to see you all soon in the next video. Thank you for watching.